Four main reasons. Kenneth Copeland is the man of sin. The man of sin is Antichrist, or the main false prophet in the context of the church. That means a form of Judas, but for the last days. I do a longer treatise of this subject in another video that is very long, that one can order from our ministry. But these are the main four reasons that I thought should catch the attention of the world, or of the church, and of anyone who has their souls to be saved when the Lord Jesus Christ returns. The first one: I was shown in a vision him admitting that he is the man of sin. We were wrestling in the spirit, or at least the spirits upon us were wrestling, and I was shown that he eventually admitted that he is the man of sin. By the way, wrestling is something that is written in the Bible, that the Christians wrestle against principalities, powers, rulers of this world, and spiritual wickedness in high places. Number two, his uniting of evangelicals with the Pope, the current Pope. They have been publicly shown to agree that the two movements, as in the evangelicals and the Catholic Church, should now cooperate. Number three, that he said God is the biggest failure. You should actually just look for a compilation of the worst quotations or the things that Kenneth Copeland has said. And this, according to me, was the most repudiating one. Number four, that he sings that his God has made a way for him. By the way, the believer's voice of victory broadcast, when they begin with a song. The song never changes. It's him changing, singing in that song. And he sings, I know my God has made a way for me. He used to sing, I know my God will make a way for me. Now he sings, I know my God has made a way for me. That is in relation to this particular verse. You should read that for yourself. Thank you.